you become increasingly aware that there is a grand design within your very life and that you have designer genes. You become increasingly aware that what is real about you, you did not inherit from your parents or your ancestors. It's a divine inheritance that you got directly from cosmic mind, all of the sacred qualities that are seeking to fulfill themselves by means of you. And that this design, when you embrace it and as you embrace it and you participate in the embracing through your spiritual practices, as we encourage you to develop your meditation practice and your affirmative prayer and your life visioning and all of the modalities that allow you to develop a conscious union with the divine, you're coming to an understanding that there is a design within you that is invisible, but your life allows it to take visibility. Just as, of course, the analogy we've been working with is that sacred seed of any particular plant or tree. Within that seed, if you dissect it, you will not see the rose bush in that seed. You'll not see the oak tree in that acorn. But there is information in that seed, invisible to the eye, a vibrational information that when placed in the proper condition and in the right season, that idea will clothe itself and unfold according to its divine pattern, according to its divine design. And from an acorn, you'll have an oak tree. From a rose, a bush seed, you'll have rose bushes. And from an apple seed, you'll have apple trees, apple pie, a forest of apple trees. Just stick with the apples, though. Anyway, don't cook everything, okay? Anyway, but the point is that there's a design in there. It's already there. And within you, there's a design from the cosmos. There's a design. As you, in your uniqueness, the way you get to reveal the infinite nature of the spirit, there's a grand design within you. And you are here to embrace this design, which is why there's the encouragement, of course, of your spiritual practices, because you do not want to live your life by default, you see? The default system of the society in which you live, of course, as we have been discussing, is mediocrity masquerading as excellence. And the society and elements within society have their designs on you. And they've got you buying stuff you don't need, eating stuff that ain't good for you. There's all manner of ways by which the design of our high-tech, low-touch society, our consumer-driven, materialistic society, has you believing you need something outside of yourself in order for you to be happy. They've got designs on your mind. It's called malicious hypnotism. And you're here to not live your life by default and have a self-fulfilling prophecy of negativity. You're here not to leave your house dirty. You're here to take an outer shower and an inner shower, meaning you have a social contract to clean up that body before you step into the public. But you have a social contract to clean up your mind and a social contract to clean up your interiority so that you're connected and unified with the one power and the one presence and the one life. So as you move out into the world, so to speak, you're moving out from within the union, the consciousness of the most high power and presence and love of God. There is a grand design, and you're here to embrace that design. And then, without mental might or coercion, that which is within you, when the condition is right, begins to unfold, to reflect, and to reveal the cosmos in a way that has never happened before, because you have never happened before. And so you'll be able to sing with our choir, "I was here because the real I am has become activated." Not your pseudo-self, not the made-up self, not the self that is praying to withstand the blows of life and developing compulsive behaviors, defense mechanisms, and things of that particular nature, and you calling that who you are. No. That when you say, "I was here," we're talking about that element of truth that's been activated in and as your consciousness, so that you get to reflect and to reveal the face of divinity as only you can. Somebody say yes.
Yes.
Somebody say, "Yes, I am."
Yes, I am.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am willing.
Yes, I am willing.
And so with this life by design and not by default, it means that you are participating in your own unfolding, which is where we are all at now at this stage of our evolution. We have to participate in our own evolution. Because if you just wait around to evolve, it's going to take hundreds and hundreds of years. And we ain't got time for you to do that. You know, there's some systemic issues that have to be dealt with on the planet. And we don't have time to wait for you to wait for everybody else to evolve before you evolve. You've got to participate in your own evolution, which is the whole reason why you have a spiritual practice, so that you can make yourself available to insight and revelation moment by moment by moment, so that that space of insight and revelation becomes the vibration by which you live from and as, and that's called inspiration. And then you become resourceful and innovative and creative, and recession brings about more resourcefulness, so that you're not bemoaning your fate and complaining about the external world. No, you're celebrating your interior awareness, your inner glow, the light, the luminosity, the light that lights up every man and woman that cometh into the world. You're celebrating that and then becoming impervious to the world. That's not living life by default. Now, if you want to know what happens if you just go outside and see what happens, you know what's going to happen. Just read the newspapers. That's what's going to happen. Wars and rumors of wars, fears, doubt, and worry. And this is hypnotism keeping you afraid of stuff you don't need to be afraid of, just so that you can be controlled and governed by individuals that want something from you that you don't want to give up. Your soul, you see? Listen to me. You are heaven bent on waking up. That's why you're here. Heaven bent on waking up. And therefore, the universe is crying out to you right now. Universe saying, brother, sister, can you spare a paradigm? That's what it's saying. It's you want what you want to be happy. You want joy. You want love. You want peace. You want harmony. You want wholeness. The universe saying, brother, sister, can you spare a paradigm? In other words, our paradigm, of course, is a way of thinking. It's a way that we perceive existence. Perceive life, perceive reality. And interestingly enough, the good and the blessings and the miraculous are right outside your present paradigm. The universe is saying, can you spare that paradigm, at least temporarily, put it to the side, not allow yourself to think through it all the time? Can you leave? You want to lose 10 pounds of ugly fat, all you got to do is release your opinions for a little while. Some of those opinions you have coagulate into jelly, coagulate into a condensation of thought and energy, and you become overweight, not just from the food you eat, but because of the thoughts you're thinking and the opinions that you're holding. I'm telling you right now, the universe is saying, brother and sister, can you spare a paradigm? Can you shift your perception for a minute? And we borrow the term from our Buddhist brothers and sisters who talk about bracketing. And that is, you take your present paradigm and temporarily bracket it. In other words, put it to the side. You know that thing within you that says you're always right? You know that one? Okay, just this side knows it. Oh, you know about it too. Okay. You're right all the time, and those opinions, those points of view, those perceptions about other people, you just take, and yourself, sometimes you're very interested in what other people are thinking about you, and sometimes you're even interested in what other people are thinking about what you're thinking about, more than what you're interested in how the presence of the universe is thinking about you. We want to take that paradigm and bracket it and put it to the side, and then we want to enter into the space of absolutely, from a feeling tonality, catching that all of our needs are met, that everything is working together for our good, that the ground upon which we're standing is holy because we're standing there, that the realm of ever-expanding good, another name for heaven, is at hand now, that the kingdom of God is within, everything is working together for our good, that life is for us, that there's nothing against us. We want to try on that paradigm for a while, which allows us to be revolutionaries, as I spoke about last week to a degree, revolutionaries in the idea sphere, that inundates into the idea sphere, the idea of oneness, the idea of connectedness with the eternal, the idea that this presence never compromises nor contradicts itself, always operating on its own behalf, so that as you begin to hold that space on a regular basis, the universal presence acting through its law embraces that space, and out of nothing, that space that you're holding clothes itself and shows up as your life and as your experience, and you will bear witness to the miraculous in your life, and you will bear witness to what is a real miracle The miracle is an instant demonstration of truth, an instant demonstration of what's already happening, but you just couldn't see it because you wouldn't break free from that paradigm. In other words, God suddenly doesn't go into the blessing business because you start praying. No. You said the magic word, you know? No. The presence of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, never changing up on itself, never compromising itself. When the universe is saying, brother and sister, can you spare a paradigm? It is saying, put it to the side for a moment. Engage in your spiritual practice. Have an insight and a revelation that's beyond your present paradigm. And then you will see miracles work in your life, not because you're special, but because you're in alignment. You see what I'm saying? You're in alignment with the fundamental harmony of the universe, you see? Because you are absolutely, so the toaster doesn't work because it's a special toaster. No, it's plugged in, baby. You know, my toaster is special. It cooks toast really good. Your toaster ain't special. It's plugged in, baby. You see? And so the same way with you.